feel old because I was a camper when he was assistant at Duke under Bill Foster. He didn't like me saying it today.
And Joe Vogel way outside. Ray Jones, who's the president of the Assistant Coaches Association, college basketball, has seen Colorado State climb within 11. Foul will be called against Vogel. Mike Brown will come in the game for Wyoming. Timeout on the floor. 11:39 to go. It's Wyoming 56, Colorado State 45.
Until now, some thought imported luxury sedans possessed a higher level of engineering. But change is on the horizon. Introducing the 1993 Cadillac Seville STS with the North Star system. At its heart, a 295 horsepower North Star V8, so advanced its first scheduled tune-up is 100,000 miles. The Cadillac Seville STS with the North Star system, changing the way you think about American automobiles.
We got ESPN next Saturday, 9 o'clock Pacific time, midnight on the East Coast. That is going to be a terrific one. Josh Grant, Gary Trost. I know I'll be listening for you, pal.
That'll be fun because BYU lost at home by one earlier in the year to Utah, and Colorado State with gave Utah their only blemish on the season.
Rick Majerus and Roger Reed.
Two excellent coaches. Very well-disciplined ball clubs.
Colorado State, who at the start of this game came up with every loose ball. Now it's Wyoming doing that. And Maroney finally clears the defensive rebound. They have cut the lead to 11.
There's 11 minutes to go. Still plenty of time for the Rams to make a run.
Well, Bobby Sellers got a good shot. A foul was not called. They see the ball knocked out of bounds by Wyoming. Connecticut beat number 17 Pitt tonight, 81-80. And Massachusetts losing by three.
How about Miami? If Leonard Hamilton could just have all his games at home, he's fine.
Mike Brown cannot turn it around. Joe Vogel for three again. The 6'10 player take those three-point shots. He dropped one earlier. That's two possessions they have not scored, and they're right now at the 10.5 mark, and a foul will be called on Aaron Atkinson. Our officials tonight, Moose Steubing, Bill Gracie, and Craig Peterson. Now, Brian Ruhr is coming back into the game for Wyoming, and Ryan Yoder comes in for Colorado State, replacing the freshman, Bobby Sellers, leaving the lineup, Mike Brown for Wyoming. Henry, Ratliff, Tata, Ruhrs, and David Murray.
Let's see if Wyoming will show a little more patience now. He's selective, operating against his zone.
Ratliff trying to post up on Vogel. This is Murray. Oh, he has been so tough. Steve,
he's so quick. He presents matchup problems if you try to go man-to-man with him. Watch him get the seam. Slips right through, and the defense gets there late. They get a three-point opportunity with that quickness. We've seen it all night long, slashing right to the bucket.
Big-time junior college player at Jacksonville, Texas. Averaged 20 points and 9 assists last year. Chose Wyoming over Connecticut, New Mexico, Arkansas, and Providence. So some big-time schools wanted this fella, and Murray decided to come to Cowboy State. He cannot finish the three-point play. It is 58-45 Wyoming. California losing badly to UCLA. That's the first loss for their new coach, Todd Bozeman. And Stanford surprising George Raveling, Trojans. Oregon beating Washington State. That's another stunner. And Oregon State losing to Washington. Nothing but upsets in the Pac-10 with the exception of UCLA over Cal. Although the Cal loss was at Harmon Arena. Mike Brown comes back in for the Cowboys. Wyoming's defense really strong. And a foul will be called on Roman Tada, who undercut Dwayne Molyneux. Roman Tada, Kansas City, Johnson County Community College. His relatives are from Sicily, and they have the Bank of Tada.
I like that.
I like that too.
Family connections.
Atkinson with the layup. Nice feed from Ryan Yoder. And again, the lead is 11 for the Cowboys.
Colorado State, though, is going to have to do it at the defensive end also. It's not their strongest suit, but they got to do a much better job of denying that dribble penetration against Wyoming.
Lewis almost traveled. Henry wants to go to Murray. Yoder's defense too strong. Shot clock at 15. Tada is fouled by Maroney.
That's the dribble penetration I'm talking about. You've got to get your body between the man and the basket. Deny him that straight line. Colorado State's had problems with that all night long. Now, the best way to deny your man getting the ball is make sure he doesn't get it. Watch this defense. This is excellent denial defense by Ryan Yoder. He's going to make sure that Murray doesn't get the ball. That's the best way to slow him down. Make sure he doesn't get the ball. That's easier said than done. Very difficult in the open court to deny that pass.
Look at Roman Tada when he shoots his free throws. I've never seen a player shoot free throws like Tada. He moves his right foot back. I mean, if you're a right-hander, you always have your right foot forward. He drops his right foot back.
Now, whatever you do, do the same thing every single time. Repetition and confidence, that's the success that a good free throw shooter should show.
Well, he said his JC coach told him to do that. Just naturally shoot your free throw. He did. He said, now stick with that. And he has. He's a 79% foul shooter, and he has given Wyoming a 13-point edge. Yoder with a huge three.
Credit Larson with an excellent screen that time, and that time Yoder ran his man right off the screen to get open for that three.
8:40 to go. That is Yoder's first three in the game. He went 4 for 5 down at Fort Collins. Tada at 6-1 found an opening down low.
Well, the bench contribution, if Wyoming goes ahead and wins this game, that's going to be a big reason why the Cowboys will come out of here with a WAC victory.
Molyneux has one man on him, but it's the best defender, and that's Rick Henry, but he goes right over him to score. 62-52, 8 minutes to go. Good pick by Roers.
That was a foot differential, 6'10 on 5'10, that time Roers and Yoder.
It's a bumping down low between Bonds and Tada. And some angry bumping. Rick Henry, not the shot they want, but it goes out of bounds to Wyoming. New shot clock at 45. We've got a time on the floor, 7:34 to play. Benny D, he's not smiling yet, but his club is in front by 10.
And Tada for Wyoming has contributed 4 points. You tend to give him a little more attention. It's a non-contact sport, right? Keith Bonds and Tada tying up inside. A lot of movement. Jockeying for position. And again, Tada 6-1. He's had a couple of buckets inside. Bonds getting a little extra attention inside.
It's Wyoming's basketball. They lead by 10, 7:34 to play. Henry inbounds to Roers.
He's got 5 seconds to release the ball. But have to touch a man within 5 seconds.
Tada misses the three. Molyneux with the rebound. It's another big possession for Colorado State. Bond struggles with it, but still scores. It's an 8-point game.
First time the Rams have had it in single digits in several minutes. And with 7 minutes plus, still plenty of time to make a run.
It's now time maybe for Murray to go to the hoop.
Right on cue.
And he scores.
He heard you, Steve.
Well, you know, you have one man on him, and forget it, it's over.
Well, he's also in a groove. He's in the rhythm. He's really looking to score, and he's very comfortable and confident once he gets the ball.
Jackson is doubled. But still drives home and cuts the lead back to 8.
Let's see if the Cowboys are a little more patient at the offensive end. It's too early to put the offensive deep breathe and not look for the shot, but be selective, be patient. Get a high percentage shot each trip down court.
Mike Brown, bad shot. And the rebound to Molineaux.
I don't know why the big guys want to shoot those fadeaway shots at the low percentage shot, plus it takes you out of rebounding position.
Ryan Yoder, a huge three, and it's 64-59. The Rams have cut it to 5.
Now I know why they call this a border war.
It is another thriller here in Laramie. 6:02 left. Colorado State coming back.
Minutes to play now.
A difficult adjustment to make is when you kind of put your offense in a neutral setting. Now to get it back into gear and look to score each trip, that's hard to sometimes make that adjustment.
Here's a defensive switch. Bonds is now covering Murray. Before it was Yoder on it.
Well, Bonds is a good defender. Member of the all-whack defensive team last year.
So Yoder goes and covers Roman Tata. Brewers. He had to take the shot, only 3 in the shot clock, and Rick Henry there for the offensive rebound, and Wyoming's back in front by 7. Stu Morrill has to be furious. His team played such good defense for 42 seconds.
Stepped on the baseline. That's the third time we've seen one of the big guys. First time for the Rams. Step on that baseline. Down low.
Cal State Fullerton beats Santa Barbara. San Diego has taken Portland. Pepperdine hammers their rivals Loyola Marymount. And Santa Clara, big win at home over Gonzaga. San Francisco, they're trying for 20 wins this year, but they lose. One of their Bay Area rivals. A turnover for Wyoming. And Colorado State gets it back, trailing by 7.
Three-point shooting has been much better for the Rams in the second half. 6 for 13 for the game, but they're 4 of 7 from three-point range in the second half.
The first meeting, they went 9 for 14 and one going away, 92-77. And Stu Morrill was telling you that, hey, we have to shoot well. We have to outscore them. They only have 59 points, and you know what they're like when they score 67 and under.
They don't get to 67, they're 0 for 7 on the years. That is a magical number if you're a Ram fan.
Runs in the drive. Beautiful pass, and Vogel slams it home to cut the lead to 5.
That's a freshman with a little authority coming through there. All right, big trip now for Wyoming. They got to get a bucket here to slow the momentum.
Well, here's Murray. Let's see if he chooses to take it. They're giving Rick Henry that outside shot, and a foul will be called. Is it against Vogel?
Coming off the screen, excellent job by Keith Bonds. Beautiful pass, and then Vogel, the freshman. Exclamation point.
The dunk off the head. I wonder if Harold Miner tried that tonight in the NBA slam dunk championship. He was the winner.
They call him Baby Jordan, and now he's got a title to go with his mentor, I guess.
Theo Ratliff misses the first end of the one plus the penalty. A 5-point lead for Wyoming. Vogel. And Ratliff grabs the loose ball. They get it to Murray. Let's see if he takes his man. He throws it away to Bonds. But Bonds falls down. And will they call a foul?
They're going to have to call a foul. That's a good call, because otherwise it would have been a turnover on Bonds. You have to make that call. Otherwise, Colorado State would have been unfavorably penalized. Watch this. Excellent hustle by Bonds. Now, the only reason he goes out of bounds is because of the bump. If he doesn't go out of bounds, there's no turnover. There's no call there. That's a good call by the official.
Yoder gets the good screen. Larson gets it back. Misses the 3, and Ratliff with another rebound. 3.5 to go. double down on Murray, so he takes everybody. What a move!
I believe Yoder's earlier defensive effort just to deny him the ball may be the best approach. Just keep it out of his hands. If you can.
Vogel is fouled by David Murray. So Joe Vogel will not go to the free throw line. He'll be there ball on the side. This is an important situation. 18 fouls on Colorado State, only two. That was the third on Wyoming. Iowa beating Northwestern. And Illinois big on Penn State. Back here in Laramie. Ryan Yoder, a three-pointer. It's 68-64. This guy is big-time pressure.
Steve Ruhrs at 6'10 was right in his face when he shot that shot. Now, once Murray gives it up, you really just got to deny him the return pass. Keep it out of his hands. Make somebody else beat you.
Yoder, after missing his first two three-pointers, has made his last three and now commits a foul on the best foul shooter on the floor for Wyoming, Roman Tada. That's the ninth team foul in Colorado State, and this is going to be an important situation down the stretch. Only three team fouls for Wyoming, and Stu Morrill's ball club down by 4 points. Roman Tada, great high school quarterback at Bishop O'Hara High School in Kansas City. Conley drops the first free throw. Wyoming back in front by 5.
That's the first time we've seen Benny D sitting down all night long. He's very active, very emotional, a lot of energy on the sidelines.
Tata misses the second. Rebounding is Henry. And he is fouled. And that is the 10th team foul on Colorado State, so it's an automatic 2 shots for Rick Henry, who is a 75% foul shooter.
Double bonus. Watch the long rebound. They don't get a good block out. That time Henry just came right back in. Now, he was the second guy in the lane for Wyoming, which meant he was up top near the free throw shooter, slid behind the defender to come up with a rebound.
2 minutes, 29 seconds left in this ball game. Wyoming trying to end a 7-game losing streak. And Henry hits both foul shots. Wyoming back in front by 7. Atkinson, a power move. He's fouled. He'll be at the free throw line. Let's see who it goes against. If it's Theo Ratliff, that will be his third and only his first in the second half after picking up 2 fouls in the first 5 minutes of this game.
Done a good job not picking up any additional fouls. Plus, with the bench scoring, that took a lot of pressure off having to play him minutes when he could have picked up that third foul in the first half.
A lot of folks could not make it to this ball game tonight. They're watching it, of course, on ESPN. But we had a very big snowstorm in the Wyoming area, and they closed down Highway 80. Benny Dees. Atkinson makes it a 6-point game.
Whole court pressure now.
They got it in Murray's hands, and he has been so special in this game. 18 points. Ruhrs is fouled by Atkinson. And they're fouling the wrong people. Ruhrs a 73% foul shooter. Tata a 79% foul shooter. And Henry a 75. Chris Fowler in our studio coming up next to talk about Grand Slam of Boxing, the NBA All-Star Saturday. What happened in the three-point shootout in the slam dunk contest, and college scores and highlights. You'll want to watch that. Plenty of upsets in college basketball. All next on ESPN. Ruhrs that misses the first of two.
Right now, 6 points. That's two possessions. This is a big free throw. It'd make it a three-possession game if Ruhrs can hit the second one.
Knocks it down. 72-65, our score. Wyoming leading. 2 minutes to go.
Now, this much time, I don't think you have to just shoot the three. Got a foul early. You don't have to just shoot the three-point shot. Still enough time where if you get a good two, go ahead and take it. You don't have to force from long range.
The fourth foul against Roman Tada. Colorado State really has to press full court, don't they?
Got to force some turnovers.
Still have one foul to give. And a foul right there. That's the 16th foul, so the next time Wyoming is guilty of a foul, they will send Colorado State to the foul line for one plus the penalty. Foul goes against Rick Henry, his second. A minute 51 to go here in Laramie, Wyoming. Bond misses the three. Yoder gets the rebound, puts it right back up. And this is terrible.
It's too early for these desperation three shots right now. You still got a minute 40 to go.
And Wyoming will have the basketball with a minute 40 to go.
Got to maintain your composure. Stu Morrill's going to talk to his kids about not having to force those things and throw up the desperation shots. Too early for that.
A minute 40 to play. Do the Rams have enough left? They're down by seven in the border war.
Hey, the way you help out around the house, like weed the
players to academic difficulties and also great players to injuries. That's Quinn Higgins. He was Alabama's high school player of the year, but three times he has damaged his knee. And again, he's missing this year, trying to come back for next season, but he is a big-time player and would have made a huge difference had he been healthy. On the floor with a minute 40 to go, Wyoming has the basketball, leading by seven. And they throw it into Ruhrs. The guy they want to foul is Theo Ratliff. He's the 51% foul shooter. Instead, they must foul Rick Henry. Wyoming has been able to thwart that run by Colorado State, the three that got them within four. Wyoming pushed them back with free throws. Dwayne Molyneux.
Well, Steve, still with a minute 31 to go, I still don't think you don't have to shoot the desperation three. If it's there, certainly pull the trigger. Otherwise, try to penetrate, try to pick up a foul, possible three-point play, or at least you're attacking. Two morals because they've lived and died by that three-point shot, but I think with a minute 31 to go, they still got enough time where they can still get a good two quickly, then set up for the full court press.
Henry makes one of two. The lead for Wyoming is now 8 points. Biggest advantage was 16. Bonds in the front court, looking for a screen to take that three. Instead, they go inside to Atkinson. He will power it up, and it's knocked away by Ratliff, his third block of the game. And he intimidated the second shot. The steal by Yoder. And Bond turns it over on the travel. Ratliff is changing the game.
This is the biggest block of the game. Excellent. Again, he waits until Atkinson commits, then sends it back at him.
Knocked it away with his left hand. He is a very quick jumper. I mean, he stays on his feet to that last second.
It also helps you avoid those cheap fouls for buying that fake early and getting out of position.
Minute five to play. Here is Tata. Ahead to Murray. Oh, man. He has been so strong. 20 points for David Murray. Wyoming leads by 10. Their longest losing streak since 75-76 may be over. And a real damage has been done to Colorado State's postseason hopes. They have 15 wins. They're looking in the face of their ninth loss of the year. We've got some fans here.
Well, I think Colorado State's going to be given a lot of consideration because of that win over Utah. They'll get some consideration for that. And they've got a couple of games left where they need to win in the regular season. Then have a strong showing in the WAC tournament. This has got to be a strong showing, though, for this Wyoming club also. The toughest thing as a player is to go through consecutive losses where they continue to mount. Mentally, it's very, very tough to get out of that mindset that how are we going to lose this one? And I think this is a very strong showing. And again, I think it goes back to what Benny D said in pregame. Talked about effort, talked about a little extra hustle, a little extra effort. In a rivalry game, hey, emotion also plays a big part.
Well, Rick Henry makes the foul shot. The kids were really fired up about being on ESPN, and they have responded with great fire tonight. Larson has it knocked away again. Ratliff is just changing every shot.
Well, right now, he's like a pass rusher in football who knows the quarterback's got to throw because he's just winding up. There's one. There's two. He'll finish with a third one, although a foul gets called there.
Five blocks now.
That talks about his quick jumping. That's a great example and illustration there of how quickly he can reset and get off the floor.
Listen for the name Theo Ratliff. Particularly next year in this Western Athletic Conference.
How about this league next year with Sean Bradley coming back, who led the nation?
Utah will lose a bunch of really good seniors, but they had a great recruiting class. Larson makes one of two. Ratliff right there for the rebound. Wyoming in front by 11. David Murray has been so special. You said Murray and Brewers had to have big games.
They have,
and Murray's responded with 20 points.
Particularly Murray. He set the tone for this Wyoming club with his penetration and his confidence scoring. Benny D said, as Murray goes, we go. Well, I think he's done well, and the Cowboys certainly have played well tonight.
They're counting it down here in Laramie. The border war in 1993. It's a split as Wyoming wins by 11.
From University of New Orleans. Jeff, the Miners starting lineup, as you would expect.
That's right. Jim Bice, Eddie Rivera will be in the backcourt. Roy Howard coming off a sensational game against the New Mexico Lobos. He has been active. He's the Miners' leading rebounder. Ralph Davis and Johnny Smooth Melvin will be at the forwards, and we see Ralph Davis has grown considerably for this game, Fred. He is now listed at 6'10". Now, obviously, that is a miscue. So, Ralph is still 6'5", from what we know. He hasn't taken anything to get him to 6'10". Believe me, Don Haskins wishes, and so does Ralph Davis, to be 6'10".
That's the Miners' starting lineup tonight.
Here's the starting lineup for the Wyoming Cowboys, and there you see Theo Ratliff. He is leading his team in block shots this year, 75. He is moving up the career list here at Wyoming. Brewers and Traylor are the starting forwards, and Roman Tata will get only his third start of the year, and David Murray, the other guard, a JC player from Jacksonville Community College. He played with Hector Gonzalez 2 years in junior college, and he's been a pleasant surprise for this Wyoming basketball team.
He is originally from New York City. He is one of the best shooters on the team. In fact, he leads the Cowboys in scoring. He's had a bit of a problem turning the ball over, however. He has already turned it over 89 times this season, and that is one reason why Wyoming ranks dead last in the Western Athletic Conference in turnover margin.
Miners lead this overall series 35-20. However, they are 11-15 here in Laramie. And, of course, that loss at home in El Paso was the first win in the 6 years that Benny Dees has been head coach at 74-70 finals. Fred mentioned earlier, with 8 seconds to go in the ball game, Eddie Rivera called that timeout that the Miners did not have, and thus they were able to make free throws down. The stretch stuttered, as we mentioned in our pregame opening thoughts. To start this ball game, Ratliff came to Wyoming. He was 6'7". Well, he is 6'10". He's grown about 3 inches since he's been here. He's only a sophomore. And he will jump against Ralph Davis, the junior from Chicago. And they take the opening tip. Tata with the basketball. Here is David Murray now. He'll bring it into the front court. Miners are going to open up in a 1-3-1 zone defense to begin things.
We should see strictly man-to-man out of Wyoming. Benny Dees has long been a proponent of chest-to-chest, man-to-man defense.
Ryan Ruhr is kicking it out, and now he gets it back from Henry, and he'll sink the jumper. So